Hi everyone, I am Dr. Rupali, specialist of infertility and IVF at Pristyn Care. So today I am here to talk about when a person should actually opt for IVF. Now there are various factors currently which are actually increasing where we need IVF or in vitro fertilization. The commonest amongst them in the females would be talking of a tubal factor. Now tubal factor, what happens in a tubal factor is that the tubes get damaged. So the main passage of the eggs to the uterus or the main passage in which fertilization takes place in a normal way gets blocked. So if that is blocked, pregnancy in a normal manner can never happen. These patients are the main group of patients where IVF is indicated. Apart from that, in patients of severe endometriosis, where we talk of grade 3 or grade 4 endometriosis, where what happens is that the eggs get trapped inside the cysts, which are called as endometriomas. They also alter the tubes. So finally, a normal pregnancy in these patients becomes a very, very difficult phenomenon. These patients can easily undergo in vitro fertilization and have much higher, much better chances of pregnancy. Talking of higher age, if the age group is much higher, if the maternal age, that is the mother's age, is very high, then what happens is that the chances that the eggs are bad or a poorer quality is much higher. So in these patients, we do have an option of producing babies, testing them for their genetic makeup, and then implanting them. More so in the current scenario where nobody wants to have babies at an earlier age. Apart from that, yes, when we are treating patients of infertility and we are treating a PCOS patient, if the patient is very resistant, we would definitely try simpler means of treatment. But towards the end, yes, in PCOS also, many patients do conceive by something called as an in vitro fertilization. Apart from that, in males, when we talk of azoospermia, more so the obstructive category, where there is obstruction to the flow of sperms. They might have normal semen volume, but yes, the sperms are deficient there or minimal. The count is very, very low. Severe oligospermia is what we talk of. There again, these patients would benefit by IVF and allied procedures like doing an ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, or etc. Apart from that, if they have ejaculatory difficulties, if the patient, the male partner, has problems in ejaculation, there again we can take testicular samples, that is, we can take sperms directly from the bag of the sperms and then do an in vitro fertilization. There is one last category which is actually really important and coming up much more nowadays, that is the unexplained factor, where as such there is no pinpointable cause, no specific cause in the patient which has been made out, and those patients also require IVF as the last or the final treatment. Thank you.